Boy, you never get tired of seeing that. A gorgeous afternoon in the Bay Area. We're going to take it to Edwards Stadium in Berkeley, California, where number 20 Cal hosts UCLA stretch run time in Pac-12 women's soccer. You take a look at the standings right now, and it's going to be an interesting weekend. Number one against number two, Stanford and USC tonight. You look at Cal's record, they're very healthy at 5-3-0 in Pac-12 play. UCLA right behind at 4-3-1. Good afternoon, everybody. Anshat's joined by my good buddy, my broadcast partner. That's Tammy Blackburn, former San Diego State standout athlete. All right, when you talk about this Cal club, as far as I'm concerned, no matter what happens, they're going to get an at-large bid for the NCAA tournament. UCLA needs to make a push.
Well, you're absolutely right. Cal is in, and Neil McGuire, the head coach, will not talk about RPI with his team. But Amanda Cromwell last weekend told her team there is no lead way left before they played Colorado and Utah. They won both those games. They know it's equally important to come in with that same mindset today.
You look at this Cal bunch, they had a very healthy non-conference win streak and then put a bunch of wins together in conference play. They've had a good season.
Well, you know what they've done is they've possessed the ball really well, and it is what they do with that ball that is even more impressive. And so they make their opponents work defensively, but they're very crafty on the ball. And one of the players that has been remarkable for them is they are unbeaten at home is this player right here, Arielle Shipp, 11 goals. She leads the Pac-12. She is a target player. She will play in the attacking midfield position today. And then how about the clean sheets for their goalkeeper, Emily Boyd. 10 shutouts.
UCLA picked to finish number two in the conference, but we know they graduated a ton of players, and it's been a rough sled.
A ton of talent who played a lot of minutes, so a lot of players coming in, and even though they were waiting in the wings, they have their growing pains. Lost four of the first seven games, but Darian Jenkins is one of those players that has helped this team, not her just her goal scoring, but her ability to keep this team on track. Now, their multiple goalkeeper situation, they are rotating through those. I promise you, you're going to love the one that they're going with right now, Siri Irvik.
Should be a fun one today. 20th ranked Cal hosting UCLA. We're in Berkeley. It'll be fun. Beautiful day for women's soccer. We'll have the lineups and opening kick coming up in just a minute. We talked about that Washington State victory for Cal. Graf with the heroics.
Oh, yeah. It's just remarkable. It was just a tough-fought battle. Anytime you go into Pullman, Washington, it's a tough place to play. And I got to tell you, Washington State is a very, very good team. But you see how that ball was shot so well. The opposite side finds the upper half just in the upper corner there. Very nicely executed by Carly Graf, who played 12 games last year. A player that, when you get the game winner against WSU, you're telling Neil McGuire, hey, I've got skill. Put me in.
Cal continuing to keep that ball in their offensive third. And here's Gibson. Finding Iffy with the touch. Off the bar. Oh, my goodness. Iffy denied again. Cal just relentless in the attack so far. The hardware rejects Anumanu's early goal-scoring bid. It was a beautiful pass into Iffy, and she unleashed a shot.
Look at the touch here by Anumanu, who does a good job of just one-timing it off her chest. The ball settles. She turns when it's happening and takes a huge shot, and UCLA got away with a good one. A lot of white jerseys inside the 18.
You're not kidding. And hovered around that six as Wittemann was able to make a run with the ball at her feet. The ball on frame, but right at Irvik. Let's see if UCLA can get something going offensively. There's a great shot of Boyd, just one shutout away from tying the all-time mark, single season-wise, for clean sheets for the Golden Bears. She has been rock solid, just a sophomore.
And no surprise, she had a great season last year, a Pac-12 all-freshman team in 2014.
Like the idea by UCLA. And Cal's defense is able to clear, but just for the moment, as UCLA will reload.
Pressure immediately by Cal on UCLA.
Let's see if the Bruins can use a little bit more of the width of the field, Tammy. Stretch that Cal defense a little bit. Smith will attract all kinds of attention whenever the ball is at her feet. Same goes for Lavrusky, who's knocked off her perch there. And here comes Cal. Nice touch by Gibson.
Short passes by Cal. Moving the ball player to player. You feel like Cal understands the cadence and the rhythm. Their tactics are very, very good. One player moving one direction, the other player taking a great angle to receive the ball. Very well organized.
One of the few times we even saw a direct kind of service just moments ago, because to your point, Tammy, short passes, a lot of possession, a lot of combination play for this Cal club at this point.
Well, we hit you with Ship right off the top in our open, and there's a reason why. She's going to play in that striker position as UCLA's Claire Winter, it looks like, is going to get called for the foul. But Ship will be that target player. She can play the attacking mid if needed, and Neil McGuire did think about that. And I thought he probably was thinking about it because of the respect he has for the defense of UCLA, that very tough back line. But at the end of the day, she's still a target here in this match, and they are looking to get the ball to Ship.
Heavy on that touch there, and Alvarado was there. Boy, how good has she been for Amanda Cromwell? Annie Alvarado with all those graduates, and she's basically stepped in as the leader and then some.
Leads by example, not just vocally, but by example.
Alvarado, the PK expert, and queen on this Bruins club. All three of her goals, if I'm not mistaken, come via the PK. Ooh, turnover. And here comes Ervic to snuff it out. That could have been disastrous for UCLA. Ervic from Norway, got some great international experience with their youth system. Played on the U19 Norwegian national team. Kind of banged up a little bit last year and finally hitting her stride in the nick of time for UCLA. Looking for that consistent keeper, and they found it in Ervic.
Annie Alvarado, just again leading by example. You see how she wants her players to come and move back to her to support her. She was calling for Serta to come back and receive that pass. You mentioned her PK ability last week on Friday, the game winner against Colorado with the PK and shots, and she went over as soon as the foul happened. She picked up the ball. She said, "This is mine."
Yep.
And the official was still, you know, booking the foul.
I love that. Everybody step aside.
That's
step
right.
Away. Got it from here.
She was very confident.
So scoreless here in the 12th minute at Edwards Stadium. Lavresky with a game winner the next game.
Against Utah, an equally important match to Friday's match against Colorado. This was Soccer Sunday. And Soccer Sunday can always be tough because of recovery. But Cody Lavresky needs absolutely no recovery. A player that is enjoyable to watch, plays with a lot of finesse. Who can forget what Cody Lavresky did in the national championship game? She had the game winner versus Florida State in that first overtime 2 years ago on the assist by Megan Oyster. It was a beautiful play.
Well, and obviously last year, UCLA loaded again, going deep into the playoffs before being stopped by Virginia and halting that huge win streak for the Bruins where they don't make the cup. So many of us were just stunned by that. And you knew graduation was going to hit this club hard, and yet it has. And yet, a run down the stretch. And I'm not sugarcoating anything. It's been a rough road to hoe for Amanda and her club. But I still think two, for sure three wins gets them in.
Yeah, absolutely. And they need 10 wins.
And I think so, too.
That's what Amanda Cromwell has been talking to the team about. And like we said in the open, it started with last week.
Yep.
There's no leadway, and this team understood that. They took that message to heart from their leader.
Well, and if they lose one of those games last weekend, they're in big, serious trouble, because it's an RPI disaster to lose to either one of those teams struggling a bit in conference play. So that's why if they can win a couple of games against the tough opponents they have left on their schedule, it really bodes well for them as far as I'm concerned.
Well said.
All right, here's Lavresky. Very tough in the one-on-one. So Gibson doesn't double-team. And the turnover will allow Cal to try the counter. Iffy has been very frisky so far. She has been very mobile, and that's a good sign for Cal. Unfortunate there for Whitteman. She thought a teammate was right on her backside as she let that ball go through.
Yes, yes, yes.
UCLA content to carry.
Look at the speed of Mace out of the back. That's what she brings to this squad. Nice step up there. Great step up by Mejia.
I really like the fact that Mace, though, saw the opportunity and just kept carrying. And if not for that step, you're right. That could have been interesting.
She will run directly at a back line, and there's nothing more infuriating than a player having to literally turn. She will turn a defender and make them chase, and that's what she does. You saw it there.
Foul goes against Gibson and the Bears. Off the post early was Anumanu's shot. That's the closest Cal has come. UCLA not really able to test Boyd yet. See what Alvarado does. Tight quarters here. Into space nicely. UCLA's got action. Miss hit there.
Great little combination play. And this is where UCLA, now they have not possessed the ball, but you see what they can do when they get a short time of possession. It wasn't a whole lot of possession there. They had to make something happen quickly. They know their chances are going to be limited by the fact that Cal will possess the ball. They're going to try to combo up front there in the final third to be creative. Jenkins on the outside was looking for something to Cody Lavrusky. A nice run.
Gabby Miranda checking in for UCLA. Nice to see her healthy again for the Bruins, Tammy.
Returned October 9th after an injury. It was the early on Pac-12 Player of the Week, and then she went out with an injury, and they missed this player.
Big time.
She's
big
very,
time.
Very composed on the ball. She's got some national under 20, under 18 experience there that they need her to, and she's great at starting the attack.
Coach Cromwell tells us that one of the real benefits of having her in the lineup, too, is that it allows Alvarado to roam a little bit more, too. Anumanu trying to put some heat on Bazia. Boure. Beautiful ball. No flag up. How about Irvin coming out to challenge Ship? Wow! Boy, Ship had a 1v1 opportunity, and Irvin comes off her line and is able to deflect that thing and keep it out of the back of the net. Wow! Clever move by Smith. UCLA, though, content to pass back and build from the back.
I really like that decision by Irvin. I mean, you've got two opportunities there, right? You've got two important decisions that you have to make. Against a player like Ship, what do you do? Well, you know, pick your poison, all right?
And pick it quick.
Irvic has to make that decision quickly, and she does. And she felt like the better chance was to go out, try to get down on the ground and put a body in front of it. Very smart player. This is why Amanda Cromwell gives her the start.
That was a tremendous save against the league leader in goals, in points, in game winners. I mean, you name it. Ship having a MVP type of season, and that looked like a sitter for a second there, but Irvic said, what are you talking about? I got this thing.
If Irvic sits on that line and makes Ship choose, Ship's very good at putting the ball and touching the back of the net. So she made it hard on Ship, and she got in the head of Ship.
Ship trying to find the runner in Wittemann, just didn't have enough on it, and here comes UCLA. Again, this is a game that UCLA has been chasing a bit, as Cal has been crisp in their offensive third, but not able to finish yet. Good idea by Lavrusky, changing the point of attack. UCLA coming from that far sideline. Smith backtracks. You don't want a turnover there, Tammy Blackburn. That's a calm UCLA presence right there, and then they kind of dump it into nothing.
Maybe trying to use the flank just a bit, and I like when UCLA uses the flank. I've seen them be very effective in terms of the means of converting flank runs into goals. But you got to break that down. You got to be well organized, and you've got a Cal defense that has made some nice step-ups defensively.
Let's take a look at that save again by Irvic. Wow.
Yeah, again, she has to make that decision. So she is going to come off her line right now. She's already chasing. She just kind of lays all out. We told you she was very good in terms of her quick reaction. She goes down on the left-hand side and boots that ball with her right foot. So she created a wall in terms of a lot of surface area, sort of eliminating any angle for Ship.
She really did. Also, while raising her arms too high, where if Ship had that split second to chip it. You know, she just really played that about as well as you could. Well done. And there's a good look at Ariel Ship, the junior forward out of California. Last year, a breakout season, and now she trumps that with the kind of year you dream about, Tammy.
She is inspired by her grandfather, yeah. Martin Solomon. And
love that.
Yeah, what a great story. We talked about it a year ago when they were in the L.A. area visiting USC and UCLA last year, about how the hotel that they stayed at last year backed up against the cemetery where her grandfather...
You can't make that up,
yeah,
can you?
That's where he was buried, and he was her inspiration. And, you know, off the field, these players do great things, Ann, and she is actually majoring in legal affairs because her grandfather, Martin, was a attorney and helped a lot of people, and her mom thinks that it's very special that Ship had the relationship with her grandfather that she did.
Ship, 11 goals, 5 assists. My goodness, does it all. It's not a black hole. She's always looking for a teammate, that's for sure. But boy, can she find the back of the net. That's what makes Irvik's save even that much more remarkable, because you're talking about the best goal scorer in the Pac-12 this year. Nicely played there by Jenkins. You got to worry about Darian Jenkins. You got to be extra special careful and mark this kid.
Tries to settle the ball, looks, and you see how she cut back. Very good texture on the ball. Good ball control, doesn't let that ball run away.
In the 18. Well, that was a long carry. And finally, UCLA's defense is able to stop that run.
Look at that turn of the ball by Miranda. Nice control there, quick turn, gets it to Alvarado, and they're already using a different side of the field.
Cal's been pressing high, too, defensively, Tammy. They really want to create the turnovers. What a step. Just brilliant there by Graff. Crowd loves it. Graff will carry. Anumanu battling. Well played by Alvarado. 21st minute. As Jenkins is down and slow to get up. We have no idea. She's limping a little bit, Tammy.
We're going to show you the play. See if we can see anything here. We don't want to speculate. You never know what happens, especially from our announced position. The bottom line is slow to get up. The head referee is over there taking a look, and now the trainer for UCLA will come out and pay a visit to Darian Jenkins, being in the first half. And the trainer being out on the field, so Amanda Cromwell will make a decision. Will a sub come in?
Jenkins, of course, the junior, leading this club with the 5 goals.
She's going to try to keep playing, as you saw. Now, you can't re-enter in the first half. If there's a substitution, it looks like she's just obviously slowed down by that. And Amber Munnerlin for UCLA will actually check in, as they will take a look at Jenkins.
Darian will get a look at by the trainer, as far as she'll take that moment. We're here in the 21st minute. And there's Munnerlin, wearing number 8 for UCLA, the 5'7 junior, a versatile player that's got the 3 goals and 1 assist. Doesn't start a whole lot, but really valuable with her time on the pitch.
Just scored a beauty of a goal against Colorado last Friday night. An absolute beauty from a play on the right flank. Did a nice job of turning and going right at the keeper for Colorado.
So Jenkins out, Munnerlin in. Scoreless here as Anamano's shot hit the hardware early in this match, and then moments ago, Ship had a 1v1 opportunity that UCLA's keeper Irvik snuffed out, so we're still scoreless. And as Lauren Hom checks in for Cal, we'll take a look at the RPI. Those numbers critical at this time of year, Tammy.
Yeah, the coaches talk about RPI, and that's all they want to talk about these days. Interestingly enough, Neil McGuire will not talk about RPI and rankings with his team. He says that will all take care of itself. If you guys play the soccer I know and trust you can play, then we don't even have to worry about RPI because it will be high enough to get us in, and I think that's a good strategy by the coach.
McGuire, in his ninth year with Cal, has just been brilliant in terms of getting his club to the NCAA tournament. Last year, one of those seasons, beat San Diego State in that first round and then lost to Florida in the second round.
It was a thrilling match. We were here for that match against San Diego State. Double overtime. They won it 3-2.
That was a huge match for this Cal bunch because, you know, anytime you get into that second and third round, what it does for your program, what it does in terms of recruiting, how you fare and how you sit in the national landscape, that's pretty big stuff.
Hard not to want to come and play for that coach right there, Neil McGuire, who all you have to do is look at what he's built and what he's done here at Cal. Not only his record, but how he's put the teams together, the strategy, the tactics that he's used to beat some big teams. Some notable wins. He is a coach who is well known for player development and skill development.
Beautiful ball by Alvarado, and Smith tries to find the head of Alvarado just beyond her reach. Nice little combination effort by UCLA. The Bruins, of course, winning that 2013 national title. Tammy told you about that. Lavrusky, such a big player in that magical moment. Amanda Cromwell in her third year. How about her starting with a bang, huh, with this UCLA program? Ship, absolutely gorgeous leaving that. Let's see if UCLA can track back. Boure, oh, the cross, and Anamano just couldn't find her foot, but still, it's an opportunity for Cal. Boure trying to track it down. Oh, man.
Anumanu was one step away from putting that ball in the back of the net.
I like the idea by Boure.
But it all started in midfield. And did you see the nice tandem play, the combo play? Boure made a run between the two defenders after she passed it, got the ball back, and then got directly inside the 18 where Cal is so good. And I'm telling you, Anumanu wishes she had one more step toward the goal because that ball would have touched the back of the net.
Free kick coming up, though, for the Cal Bear Club. Wonder if Emma Fletcher with those orange boots will take it. Serta and company trying to get organized with the wall. Dangerous situation for this UCLA defense. Like the idea, Fletcher trying to keep that ball in the offensive third. Nicely played by the Bruins. That was Miranda that got her club out of trouble. Like the idea by Cody, but that's an awful lot of real estate to cover. And here comes Cal again. Great tackle by the Bruins there. Nicely played by Goralski. Alvarado goes down, but UCLA will play on.
No whistle. Nope. Advantage. Yep. UCLA stays the same, so the head referee going to let him play. I like that call. You don't want to disrupt anything, especially if UCLA is connecting. Definitely would have been a foul call. They would have had a free kick, but
just a gorgeous day here in the Bay Area. Cal hosting UCLA, the 20th-ranked Bears, trying to post a rare victory over UCLA. The Bruins owning this series for the most part, winning 10 straight. The last time Cal has won, Tammy, 2004. Fletcher will play it back.
Well, the defense of Cal is making it so difficult for UCLA to make a run forward, much less get end line, which they like to do and can be very effective when they do get end line.
Anumanu. Nice tackle by Bazia, but it'll be a corner.
UCLA has been playing defense much of this first half. A great step as Anumanu tries to turn the corner on Bazia. Bazia has to try to make a slide tackle late to save that. Anumanu had a little bit of room if she was going to turn the corner. Nevertheless, Cal's going to get an opportunity to set something up here in the corner slot with the corner kick.
Cal, just a different club with Anumanu on the pitch. Ship, beautiful ball. A touch. Oh my goodness, can Cal buy a break? I don't think so. Off the post again. This time, Mejia with the shot and a rocket that the hardware denies again, Tammy.
It's just beautifully played, though. I mean, I think this ball on the turn and then sent opposite across the opposite side of the field really surprised the defense for UCLA, and they just caught a huge break.
Whoa.
This reminds me for Cal of USC that at times has been so close and yet so unlucky.
And that's what it's been. Two shots. Hitting posts, and then Ship denied in the 1v1 opportunity against Irvin. But Cal will not stop the pressure. Boure tries to cross it right there at the top of the six, but UCLA's defense denies again. Ship knocked down. Nothing called, Tammy Blackburn. The home fans do not like that.
A bit of physical play here. And you can see the defense for UCLA, they just don't want Ship to get the ball and turn the corner. Ship's surprised as she sits up and looks and says, hey, give me a break.
I think a lot of folks anticipated a whistle there. That's a lot of contact on Ship. Ooh, near disaster there as Cal almost put the ball right at Lavrusky's feet. So Kasky will check in for UCLA. Serta out, still scoreless, 30th minute.
Kasky, a lefty, so she's going to run over on that left-hand side of the field. She'll play up the flank. She's good in the middle. She's a very good passer. Problem is, in order to pass the ball, you got to have the ball. And Cal has had the ball
most
of this first half. Let's go back to that ball off that post.
Oh, man.
Siri Irvik. Standing there with her legs spread apart wide going, how did that ball not go in?
And another player that's down and slow to get up is Ty, number 19.
It's a big loss if Mad Ty goes to the bench.
Well, it looks like that's exactly what's happened as number 77, Courtney Proctor, who's had some injury problems herself, coming onto the pitch for the UCLA Bruins. So the second Bruin to go out, Jenkins the first one getting banged up, Ty the second.
Courtney Proctor, they are glad to have her healthy. She has played in some games this year. It is good to see her back, as you mentioned, but she's not as experienced with minutes, so she's going to have to be absolutely spot on as she will be in charge in that center back position of making sure that Ariel Ship, number 10 White, go ahead and mark it. Proctor, number 10 for Cal. She is going to be your assignment at times.
Ship uses the angle, now tries to body the defender. Ship really doesn't have any help. Ship gets creamed again, this time by Mace, and the whistle does blow on this occasion.
And watch this chase here. Watch Ship trying to get her left shoulder, try to go into Mace. Ship will oftentimes try to settle, turn, hold the defender with her backside hips.
Gibson, interesting ball that Adumanu really couldn't handle. Got a foot on it. but loses the touch, and here comes UCLA with a slow buildup. The last three games of the regular season start today for both of these clubs. UCLA, tough road to hoe, at Cal today, obviously, at Stanford, and then hosting USC. Simply three of the top, if not the top, teams in the conference, Tammy. Basically, Cal mirrors that. Not exactly what Cal had in mind in terms of clearance, and it'll be a UCLA throw-in. Cal will host USC next and then be at Stanford to close out the regular season. Here's UCLA right outside the 18. Mishit by the Bears, so UCLA will possess. Patient UCLA attack. Kind of going east and west right now, Tammy.
Man, look at the pressure, though.
Yep.
Is that Bure on that far side? It is.
It is.
She's trying to push up. You turn the ball over there, and these Cal players, they're off to the races. They're running, and they've got numbers.
Well played.
There it is.
On cue. Yep. What a ball. Anamano couldn't quite catch up. Fletcher had a nice idea there. Lavrusky, triple team.
Yeah, she's going to see that type of pressure. That's the respect that her opponents have.
Well, Fletcher gives it up. And I was waiting for the flag to come up. I couldn't tell if it did or didn't, but Boyd was smart to just play that to completion. Cal's defenders wanted the offside flag, and Boyd was there because it never came up, Tammy. Fourth minute. UCLA using its bench. As a couple of starters have been dinged a little bit and have gone to the sidelines. A couple of shots off the post for Cal. This could be 2-0, 3-0 kind of a first half, Tammy, with
sure.
any luck.
Yeah, good point.
If you're Cal.
And Cal's defense has been the key, but it really is their possession as well. So
yes.
Their step-ups have been great in the back line. They've just, you know, they have disrupted any sort of runs. And when I think of UCLA, I think of a team that does want to push as high up the field as they can, whether that's in the flank, to try to get in line. You know, they're very good at making runs, near post, slot runs, far post, using the secondary offerings that they have inside the box, but Cal has not allowed any of that to manifest here today.
Miranda leaving it. Let's see if Smith can do something with it. Excuse me, that's Munnerlin. Ooh. Boy, Miranda had an idea, and that lefty, that left peg, just a little high, but she wound up and gave it a whack.
Well, you know, that's why I love Cody Lavrusky, because that play started with her idea, and it's her creativity to play that ball back and give Miranda that opportunity to take this shot. It had to be quick. Again, Cal limiting UCLA's chances, opportunities, and even possession. There was no possession. Lavrusky plays it quick with creativity. No finish there, but good idea.
And it results in a corner kick. So UCLA will take that. Here's Caskey. Cal just boots that into space. It'll be a Bruin throw-in, but it'll allow the Bear defense to get reorganized. Get the shake back. Both teams pressuring the ball, looking for that turnover. Ah! he using all 5'8 of that frame to head that ball out of danger. Anumanu, who was injured in that game against USF, San Francisco, still getting that fitness back, Tammy. Great to have her on the pitch, but you know she's going to get winded and a little gassed in some of these longer minutes in terms of games played.
Yeah, and it was unfortunate. You know, some things happened in that USF game that really kind of changed what Cal looked like for a little while, but Neil McGuire says he was really proud and pleased with the way his team kind of reacted to the adversity.
Yep. Free kick. Punched out of the way by Irvick instead of gobbled up. Munnerlin not able to control. So Cal will start from midfield here in the final minutes of the first half. We're in the 38th minute. Scoreless here at Edwards Stadium on this glorious day for soccer. Wow. Turnover. Here's Wittemann, able to turn.
Miscommunication there with Wittemann and Iffy. Wittemann thought that Anumanu was going to make a run on the inside of the defender, Bazia, but instead she tried to bend around Bazia, and that little miscue right there, that would have been a really good look if Anumanu could have gotten that touch on that play, nicely laid out by Wittemann.
Just a great hustle play by Wittemann. It looked there for a second that Cody was going to have some real estate to play with Lavrusky. But Wittemann chasing that down and causing the turnover. Here come the Bears again. As complete a player as you'll see is Sam Wittemann, no doubt about it. Iffy working with Ship. Nice step. Ship, though, gives it up. UCLA's defense bending a little bit, but not breaking, and loving the help from the hardware.
Yeah, and remember, Madison Tye for UCLA. She had to come out. She was banged up just a bit, so they subbed her in. Courtney Proctor, not a lot of minutes, steps in that center back position. Has to go up against a player like Ship, who wears number 10 for Cal. And there you saw Proctor, number 77 for the Bruins, run right at her. Ship was trying to be as quick as she can, but a good job by UCLA to disrupt any attack and potential chances. Nice to see Ship, who is healthy. You know, she's always been a great goal scorer. In fact, highly touted and recognized out of high school as being one of the greatest goal scorers. So a lot of people thought she would come in and do that. But she was banged up just a little bit this year. Healthy, fit, coming off a great summer. You and I know that. Neil was talking to us about that.
And the fitness, he says, has really allowed her to not only be physically that much sharper, but mentally that much sharper as well.
And she can get to the right spots and be even more creative and more lethal of an attacker.
Back heel for Wittemann. Into space. Let's see if Gibson can track it down. She can.
No cross, no cross. Get
off! Wittemann, very dangerous and clever here. She'll carry and leave it. Iffy whiffs on that one. I think Mace kind of disrupted her a little bit. But here comes Hom and the Bears again. Oh, that was a situation you know Anumanu wants back. Man. That's just a great ball. And giving chase is Munnerlin. Just a little heavy on the touch is Amber. What a ball from Kasky, excuse me, to Munnerlin. Wow.
Oh, boy. Good hustle. And then Munnerlin actually is going to get called for the foul as the hustle there by Sandra Lay comes over. I mean, that is what Sandra Lay is known for. That's what she adds to the pitch. She's a very calm leader. I remember watching her play last year.
Cal again, nearing the top of the 18. Is that the one that gets home? Well, it sure as heck is. And finally, Cal is on the board here in the 41st minute. A great run of play tally.
and there was nothing Irvick could do about that one. So Ship picks up goal number 12, and that was a team effort, Tammy Blackburn.
Well, they moved the ball up the field so nicely, but it happens quickly. Now, we just saw the ball at the opposite end with UCLA, and it started from the free kick. They moved the ball up to the middle third, and then in the final third, they make things happen. They put bodies in the box. They've got good options, but it's all about finding the space, and how about the shot? The clinical finish, what she simply does there, she keeps her composure. You know what she did? She didn't put too much on it. She passed it to the corner of the net.
She sure did. And I'm not going to say, oh, yes, I am, that darn near hit the post again. That thing barely curled in. And there was nothing Irvick could do about that. And the quick strike by Ship. Wow, goal number 12. She just adds to her totals. Desiree Ship, who is having a phenomenal year. Just a junior, Tammy.
Vying for Player of the Year, Pac-12 Player of the Year, would be really hard not to give it to this player. I know there's a lot of other deserving players here in Pac-12 women's soccer, but the numbers are outstanding. I'm not sure anybody outperforms Ari Ship.
Well, gosh, I mean, the 12 goals now to go along with the 5 assists, goodness sakes. Those are numbers that tell you she's in the right place at the right time for herself and her teammates. UCLA now chasing. Cal is a very good front-running team, Tammy Blackburn. And it was just a matter of time, as far as I'm concerned, before they found the back of the net.
Well, they're a good front-running team, and let me add that UCLA has found themselves in a bit of trouble this season by being late in the game with goal scoring, right? And so they've allowed their opponent to score first. They have found themselves in the opposite end of the spectrum this year, as Amanda Cromwell says, the opposite end of the spectrum. How do you dig out of a hole? How do you go and battle uphill? That's what this UCLA team is going through.
Another look at the goal.
Again, you have to just pass the ball to the corner. It didn't need a whole bunch on it. And she's just calm and composed, and I like that really easy finish and the celebration by Cal. They understand how critical it is to go up and put that first score on the board.
So Niled in, Ship out. Ship denied by Irvick with that sensational save earlier in the half. But I think you put it beautifully, Tammy. Didn't try to, you know, knocked the stuffing out of the ball, just slotted it where the goalkeeper wasn't and basically passed it to that far post, didn't she?
How many times do we see in soccer players who can't finish because they get it's too exciting for them? They try to put too much on it. Sometimes you just want them to pass, and that's what she did to that corner. Ari Ship, 12 goals, the next closest. Kelly Farquharson of ASU with 6. Caitlin Johnson, a couple of players for WSU with 6 apiece as well. She's doubled that performance.
Niled can't catch up. Nice idea by Whitteman and a pretty good run by Niled. Just didn't have the foot speed. There's a nice shot from behind of Ari Ship. And Cal, let's give credit where credit is due, has been relentless in the offensive third. Just attacking that Bruin defense and looking for the opening that would finally get them on the board.
Is there a position or a positional player on this pitch that has not been spot on and played their role and made everybody else, the other 10 on the pitch with them, better? I mean, their connecting, their cadence, their rhythm, their understanding is so good.
Vandy Veeder also on the pitch for Cal in a substitution role. Let's see if UCLA can dial up some magic. Nice tackle. And Bure is going to give it up. Smart play by Bure. Whitteman into traffic. And UCLA is going to have to hurry to get something with the buildup starting from the back. Kate Scott is waiting in our Pac-12 studio. She'll handle halftime for us. In other words, you are in good hands, viewers.
That's right, Kate Scott doing a remarkable job.
That's right, Kate, remarkable.
Enjoyed spending a little time with our friend Kate Scott at Women's Basketball Media Day just a couple weeks ago.
Let's see if Bure can get something. Proctor says, no, sir. But the goal by Ari Shipp in the 41st minute, Tammy Blackburn, has given Cal the 1-0 lead here at halftime.
You know, Neil McGuire is going to be very impressed, very pleased with what his team has done. It's the possession. It's the carefully and creatively moving the ball around, shifting the point of the attack, but also being direct if you have to and being quick, and then Shipp with the finish.
Speaking of Cal and Neil McGuire, he joins us and slips the headset on. In terms of possession and giving yourself quality chances, Neil, that was a heck of a first half.
You know, we're very pleased with that. We talked about time of possession as being the most important statistic, and I thought our girls did a nice job. UCLA are very talented in the front five, and our girls had to have guts to play that way, so I'm proud of them.
Neil, absolutely no doubt UCLA wants to get end line, and they are very good when they do get end line, but your steps and your defense has been locked in and clogged any possibility for them to do that. Was that a strategy, something you guys worked on in practice earlier this week?
Well, we're well aware of their ability. I mean, Darian and all the other strikers they have, I mean, it's unbelievable. So we wanted to make sure that we were tight, take away the ability for them to face us, because when they face us and they've got speed, it's a challenge for us. So our girls did a nice job.
Neil, thanks so very much. Great first half by the Bears. Good luck down the stretch. That's Cal head coach Neil McGuire. He had to have liked that first half. The hardware stopped his club from getting on the board, but then it was Shipp that said, not this time, 1-0. Golden Bears at half over UCLA. Kate, take it away after these breaks. He said on the Pac-12 networks tonight, the top two teams in the conference squaring off, USC at Stanford.
Oh, that is a huge billing. This matchup has been something that we've been talking about, well, for the past 7 to 8 days, and a lot of excitement. All you got to do is go to Twitter and either Stanford women's soccer or USC women's soccer to feel the excitement. Cal at 5-3-0, UCLA at 4-3-1. But look at the top two, Stanford, USC, and USC trying to give Stanford their first loss by wiping away that clean sheet to share a Pac-12, a bit of the Pac-12 title.
That'll be fun. JB Long and Krista Blunk on the call. All right, but that's tonight. Right now, first half, Cal hosting UCLA, and it's really been all Golden Bears.
Cal did a great job of possessing the ball and working their way in. In the final third, they were literally trying to get the ball in the back of the net each and every time the ball was at their feet, and they had some very good chances, some unlucky shots that went their way off the far post, the side post, but it was Shipp who passed the ball nicely on the ground to the corner of the back of the net, that is, to get the score.
All right, what numbers jump out at you, partner?
Well, the corner kick situation, I thought UCLA needed and would have more corner kicks in this match, but you have to credit Cal's defense for not allowing them to put pressure on them and their great steps, and of course, 6 shots for Cal, UCLA only 1.
And the score is 1-0, Cal. Ari Shipp, obviously a front runner for a conference player of the year.
Just an absolute remarkable job. She says that Alex Morgan, the former Cal Bear and a player who is on an amazing, famous world tour as of late, is her inspiration. And she plays a lot like Alex Morgan, just a very hard worker, a crafty player. You come to a real admire where Shipp has taken the level of her soccer.
So Shipp with her 12th goal of the season coming in that first half. Graf with her first assist of the season. She was the one that found Shipp, and boy, Ari quickly put that thing gently into the back of the net. And that's where we stand, 1-0, Cal with the lead. And know this, the Golden Bears, a very good front-running team. They're 6-0-1 when leading at half. They're 11-1-1, Tammy, when scoring first. Yeesh.
Well, UCLA's going to have to dig themselves out of a hole. They need to score, and there is Darian Jenkins coming out of the half. In the first half, she didn't see 45 minutes of playing time. When she went down, she was slow to get up. And you can see that they absolutely need her on the field for her ball control and her ability to score, but something slowed her down. Mm-hmm. Trainer came out, she walked off the pitch.
And joining us is Amanda Cromwell, the third year head coach for UCLA. How is Jenkins doing, coach?
She actually tweaked her knee in warm-up, which is unfortunate, so she'll be limited, but we're going to put her back out there.
Amanda, one of the things that your team is so good at, one of the things I know you want to do is really try to push the ball, get in line, and use the ability to make a nice run to the near post, slot run, what have you. But Cal's defense has really stepped up and done a nice job. What can you do to get back to end line in this second half?
They came out and pressured us, and we hadn't had that in the last two games. And I think our girls were a little frazzled by it. And we need to look higher and make sure we hold the ball. We had way too many unforced turnovers.
Still very much in this thing, Amanda. Thanks for joining us, and good luck this second half. That's UCLA head coach Amanda Cromwell. In just her third year, the run that she had at UCF Central Florida was very, very impressive, and I think a great nod by UCLA's administration to give her the job and obviously win that national championship right out of the chutes.
Yeah, she's a great coach. She does a real nice job with the players. Last week, she actually told us when we were talking to her about just the frustrations and some of the struggles of having to build this team back up from losing those nine players that graduated, a lot of minutes by those players. She said, I wouldn't trade this team in for any other team in the world. She absolutely loves this team.
Second half underway, Whitteman carrying. Just to remind you that the 20th ranked Cal Bears are hosting UCLA. Cal in their home kits of white shorts, shirts, and socks. UCLA with their road gear. Blue and black shirts with the black down the sides, black shorts, and blue socks. Edwards Stadium here in Berkeley, 72 degrees, Tammy. Wind's barely a factor at about 10, 11 miles an hour out of the west. Beautiful day.
You dialed that up for me.
Yeah? Good. I want to keep you informed. So a big Thursday for Pac-12 women's soccer with this match here in Berkeley and then USC at Stanford. Number two at number one as far as the conference is concerned in the standings. 7 p.m. will be your kickoff for that match. J.B. Long and Krista Blunk on the call.
Stanford leads the all-time series with USC, 16-4-3, including a 1-0 victory last year in L.A. on that first career goal by Hannah Farr. But it's USC who comes in, holding their opponents scoreless over the past 275 minutes.
That'll be a fun match. You know, we talked with Coach Cromwell, and I think she astutely said, hey, we've got to figure out their ball pressure and not turn the ball over. Offensively, from your mind's eye, Tammy, what does UCLA need to do to get their attack where it's really pressuring Cal? Well, we'll hold here as Cal off the turnover looks to do something quickly. That ball not cleared, and Irvick finally dives on it. Wow, and Fletcher was right there.
That ball dangerously loose inside the goal box. Siri Irvick has to go down and just smother it quickly. But look at the push all the way to the end line. And then did you see the defense draw toward? And then so something opened up. A nice run there to an open space.
Well, and that's the last thing UCLA can do is give up another goal via the turnover. Fletcher very close there. All right, back to UCLA. What must they do offensively, Tammy?
Well, I think Amanda Cromwell said it. You know, I think they have to look higher. Sometimes you can look a lot side to side. Sometimes you have to go negative in order to bring it back up. Sometimes UCLA is very good quickly, and they can play direct soccer if they need to. They've definitely got speed up top.
Wally into space, nobody there. Heather getting the starting nod for this Cal bunch in the second half. The sophomore who did not start the game but starts the second half. And that's interesting because Wally didn't even... Ah, she did start the game. That's my bad. Here's Heather again. Nicely played by Wally. There it is. And just like that, I mean, no defense at all by UCLA. And it's 2-0.
If I'm not mistaken, I think that was an own goal by UCLA. I think Bazia.
Let's take a look because there was no defense, that's for sure.
That we're up here in our announced position. We are looking directly into the sun, but
yep.
That's an own goal on Bazia's UCLA, and she puts her head down as she knows it. That's a tough one because that separates Cal now. And they are up 2-0, a bigger hole for UCLA to have to climb out of.
I thought that ricocheted off of a Cal Bear, but you're right. I was thinking to myself, absolutely no defense, and that's because it went off a defender. Oh, man, that's just unlucky. Wow.
That's a big turning point in this match.
Oh, and you just feel for Bazia. Anumanu does a nice job of keeping the defender at bay. Whitteman wanted to redirect that header.
And don't think that Cal is going to sit back and relax and just try to defend and possess the ball. They're going to keep their foot on the pedal and maybe even press a little bit harder.
All those shots that hit the post for Cal, they were the kind of the unlucky bunch in that first half. Finally got the goal from Ship. But then right off the boot of Bazia for the own goal. Oh, man. Now there's a big road to climb. And there's a lot of curves and bumps and bruises for UCLA along the way. You need to get it back fast, Tammy. Munnerlin gets it right back. Lavrusky, oh, just turned and didn't see it in time. Into space for Proctor. She felt iffy coming. And here was the own goal, Tammy.
Yeah, this is a good look from behind the net. And you see it was just a really bad touch by Bazia. I mean, that ball came off the outside of her foot. Naturally, it's going to go right in the back of the net. Siri Irvik couldn't obviously do anything. And she didn't expect that ball to come to her. She wasn't even in the position to make a dive to save it.
Bazia, a recent starter for this UCLA bunch, the redshirt freshman. Munnerlin will carry. Nice step, beautifully done by Boure. Ship. Look at that ball. Iffy. Bam!
Boy, Cal makes it look so easy. The runs that they're putting together and connecting. Starts at about midfield. Boure has her foot on the ball, and everything builds up from the turnover. And here it is. Look at the step, the takeaway, and watch the composure that Cal has on the ball, and then the run on the opposite side. A nice through ball through the defense there. And Anumanu chases it down. She gets out ahead and makes it look so easy.
All started with the step by Boure. All started with that step to make it 3-0. And here comes Cal again. Wally. All right, we talked about the multifaceted and talented Ari Ship. So she picks up yet another assist. That's number 6 on the season to go along with goal number 12 today. Heck of a performance, and we've got a long way to go.
I mean, her numbers are remarkable in terms of scoring, but the fact that she also is a playmaker and dishes it off and makes her other teammates around her better, puts the ball right where it needs to be. I mean, she led Anumanu to that goal. She fed that to her so nicely.
Iffy leading this club with the 5 helpers, the 5 assists. That's her 3rd goal of the season. And again, a banged-up, star-crossed season and career for Anumanu. With that ACL last year, and when she's on the pitch and getting that fitness level back, this is a different Cal club. Jenkins carrying. 3-0 Cal. Jenkins again with the turn. Oh, Lavrusky making that run, Tammy, just couldn't get a noggin on it.
One more time to look at this goal. Boure starts it. She picks the ball away from UCLA. Ship with the assist. And she puts it right out in front. And Anumanu, all she has to do is touch it, pass it to the opposite corner. Siri Irvik goes out, tries to lay out, maybe tap it or touch it with her right foot. Anumanu says, no way.
And I love Ship's reaction. She gets more juiced up, Tammy, with the assist than she does when she scores. Love that.
All you have to do is go back to the beginning of this year. It was a week to remember after a stellar performance at the Duke Nike Classic for Ship, where she saw her hand and shots in all 4 goals that Cal scored to draw against number 4 North Carolina and win at number 16 Duke. Of course, then followed up by the consensus national player of the week honor for her.
She got all lathered up with that hat trick against Hawaii, and then against those big name clubs that you mentioned. What a start to the season, and she has never let up. Ship has been fantastic. Last year, she has the 4 goals and 2 assists, Tammy. Right now, 12 goals, 6 assists. How do you not give her player of the year? With all due respect to Sullivan and the other great players in this conference, how do you not give it to Ship?
Yeah, she's definitely the front runner.
No question. Of course, I'm usually wrong, but what does that have to do with anything? Nah, but I'm serious. I'd vote for her early and often when it comes to conference player of the year. So again, this is a Cal bunch. When scoring first, 11-1-1. And it was 1-0 at half. An own goal makes it 2-0. And then Anumanu slots home goal number 3 for Cal, and that's where we stand. And Tammy, if you're the Golden Bears, are you just thinking, let's just have fun, stay frisky, stay fresh, let's pile it on?
I'm thinking they're not going to take their foot off the pedal, and I said that after the own goal, and of course they didn't. The great run by Anumanu. I mean, it's not a Cal team that's going to let off. They're going to play Cal soccer. That's the only way that they know how to play. They play with one speed, and that is hustle at all times. You see the pressure every time UCLA receives the ball, pressure on.
From opening kickoff, we've seen that.
Mm-hmm.
Nice job by Munnelin to keep that ball in play. Jenkins tries to turn. Just nicely played by Cal. The defense has been so steady. Mejia, as steady as it comes. Ship got tugged, and when she lost the ball, the whistle blows, so it'll be a free kick for the Bears. Let's see.
Ship flat out stopped playing. She stopped this run. Look at this. That's oh. She said, come on. And then, of course, as soon as Madtai touched it,
yep.
The referee blew the whistle. So free kick here.
Saturday. It's a spooky good doubleheader. First at noon, despite suffering key losses on both sides of the ball, UCLA looks for a critical conference win over gutsy Colorado. And at 4,
passion and energy, toughness and physicality.
Utah's pursuit of an unforgettable season continues, playing host to Oregon State. Halloween doubleheader coverage begins Saturday at 11 with a pregame show on Pac-12 Network or watch on Pac-12 Now.
Over 30 yards out, roughly, right about maybe 30, 32 yards out.
Bure's got a great leg. Let's see what she does if anything's on frame. Miss hit there. Bure's going to try and keep it in play. Nicely done by Alvarado. And here comes Munnerlin. Lavrusky is going to give way to Munnerlin. Jenkins disrupted just a bit by Graff. Nice poke by Graff there to allow her defense to get organized.
Munnerlin holds off the defender and draws a corner kick for UCLA. You know, you just want this UCLA team, I've wanted them all year, to just be finishers in the final third, more creative in the final third, an area where they just haven't really been, well, like they were in the last couple of years, and rightfully so, graduated a lot of talent, but they've really had to try to find that, and they've been working at it, just hasn't quite come to them.
So here's the corner for UCLA. Let's see if they can get back in this thing. Miss hit there. Can ill afford those kind of missed opportunities. Munnerlin, the transfer from UNC, that's a nice get for the California kid coming home.
Great ad for UCLA, and there was no question that Anson Dorrance just did not want her to be where she wanted to be, and Amanda Cromwell wanted to make sure that that was all fine, so called right away, and no questions asked. Absolutely, the transfer happens.
Whitman will leave it. For Iffy inside that 18 again. Whitman, little tap. Oh, great save. Graff is denied. Still that ball in play. Irvik again.
Two great saves by Siri Irvick. Cal not done yet. Wow, Irvick was peppered and stood strong and stayed home.
Well, she's very, very good in these situations where she has to be quick on her feet, quick reaction. She was that way last weekend, and she has been proving to bring that in this Cal match. When she has a chance to see the ball, she can react quick, put her hand on it, put her foot on it. Very, very good in those circumstances. Just hasn't, in those other three goals, wasn't really put in that situation.
What a flurry by Cal, almost putting number four on the board. Jenkins with the great foot speed inside the 18. She goes down. And the whistle blows. No doubt about that one as Jenkins is tugged down from behind. And that means it's Annie Alvarado time.
Watch her go over and she'll pick up the ball as she's doing right now. Annie Alvarado already has the ball in the spot where she wants to kick it. But let's go back to the foul. Jenkins had to turn the corner and either get a shot on frame, put the ball across, or draw the foul. She draws the foul. This was beautifully played as that ball runs away, but her hustle and staying in that play, not holding up.
Annie Alvarado, 3-for-3 in PK situations. All goals coming via the PK. Oh boy, that kind of day. That kind of day. And you know what, Tammy? That wasn't even close. Wow.
This is a rare miss by Annie Alvarado. She knows exactly where she wants to put it, but as soon as that ball comes off her foot, she turns around, puts her head down. Look at the hands on the head. That is a big sign of disappointment by that player right there. She absolutely knows it.
Had been automatic as the clean sheet is intact. And know this, Boyd guessed right. If that thing would have been even kind of on frame, Boyd probably would have made the save. See for yourself.
Watch the timing here, and Boyd would have definitely had a hand on it.
Pretty good chance, unless it would have gone under the mitt. But that shot sailed way wide, and the clean sheet is intact for Emily Boyd. Just one shot out away from tying the single season record set in 96 for shutouts. Defense would love to give her that moment here at home. Cal with the corner kick. My goodness. I mean, I put a buck on the table every time Annie Alvarado puts that ball down in the spot kick area. She's been so certain with those PKs and missed badly, Tammy.
Watch out. Ashley Silprizio, who was the last to earn 10 clean sheets in 2005. Emily Boyd is chasing.
Ship, dummy run. Vandy Veeter was right there, cleared for just a second.
Emily Boyd has picked up quite the honors this season. A couple times Pac-12 Player of the Week or Keeper of the Week, if you will. Her goals against average coming into this match, 0.547. Leads the Pac-12.
You bet, baby. So leads the conference in goals against average and shutouts. We're now talking Emily Boyd.
Now, the goal against average, she will point to equal parts success with her back line.
Uh-oh. Ship! Oh, my goodness. There's the brace for Ship as she just takes it right away from the UCLA defender and buries it here in the 61st minute. That's all Ari Ship.
Well, this is just a tough place to turn the ball over. And when you've got a player as quick as Ship, who will take advantage of a turnover, especially in that position, and look at the reaction of it. Emily Boyd celebrating.
You know, and I'm telling you, Tammy, goals have been hard to come by for this Cal group. A lot of one-goal victories. 3-2 against Oregon, 1-0 Oregon State, 1-0 Santa Clara, 2-0 against Utah, and then a win and a loss by one goal for this Cal bunch. And they've exploded today.
It all starts with the tempo and the momentum coming out of the locker room. That first goal was an own goal by UCLA for Cal. And it gave them everything that they need to just continue to move forward. The through ball, Anumanu hits it in the back of the net, and then Ship with her second. I don't want to put anything on Courtney Proctor for UCLA, who is playing in the center back position defensively for UCLA. She just hasn't played a lot. She just doesn't have game experience, and that turnover was tough, and you're going against the potential Pac-12 Player of the Year. Corner, again, mishit by UCLA. So 4-0, it was 1-0 at half after Irvik had a sensational save, a couple of Cal shots, hit the post, Ship finally able to break through, 1-0, still anybody's game, and then man, that own goal just opened up the floodgates, and here we are, 4-0, Golden Bears. Again, this relentless Cal defense forcing turnover after turnover. Ship now with 13 goals, more than doubles her advantage over a bunch of players with 6 goals going into play this weekend. Nice job by Jenkins. And I'm not putting anything on Alvarado, but boy, they needed that PK in the worst way, didn't they?
Would have been different, right? You're on the scoreboard, it's a different feeling.
Yep.
She is the vocal leader. Annie Alvarado,
Boy,
one that leads by example.
She and just kind of closes her eyes and holds her head. Are you kidding me?
Doesn't want to let her team down. Meanwhile, Darian Jenkins is off the pitch now. It was a good question you asked, Ann Schatz, with Amanda Cromwell at the half about how is Darian Jenkins. Did not know that she was banged up in warm-up
right
before, so she was obviously dealing with something in that first half coming into the match that took her out.
You don't want to chance anything with your club trailing by this much here in the 64th minute. If he will carry and look to cross. Ship, the dummy. Oh, what a save. What a job by Irvik. As Fletcher was bearing down, clever sequence by Cal. And I'm going to tip my cap to Siri again. Check it out, Tammy.
Just some great work here. Cal just peppering Irvik with challenge after challenge. Mm. She has to get up quick, lay down on the ball.
Well, I'm impressed by Irvik.
I promised you at the top.
You did.
I not? I said you will absolutely love her game.
So Serta back on the pitch, coming in for Jenkins, I believe. Boy, I think Irvik's going to be able to break down the video after this game with the goalkeeper coach, and they're going to find a lot of positives in this recent starter for UCLA, minding the nets. She's been fantastic.
Earned her first career start against Arizona.
Yep.
She was less than 5 minutes away from a clean sheet in that match, and that's a good Arizona team.
Oh, man.
A very good Arizona team. Thought that would be a turning point in the season for UCLA, and then some more bumps and bruises on that road that
yep.
you were talking about earlier.
Flick header. Boyd comes off her line to snuff it out. Boy, what a great through ball by Lavrusky, and Boyd, shutout is intact. Wow, UCLA putting a little pressure on Cal. Graf on the counter, and here is Fletcher, the transfer from LSU.
Had a notion to run at that back line, but pulled up and goes out wide. Good decision.
Whitteman. Like the idea, Sam Whittam.
Again, UCLA trying to put the ball on frame, but Emily Boyd steps out, makes a big stop. Boy, these keepers have treated us to some delightful plays with their feet and their legs. Their positioning when they get down to the ground.
Sort of so close, just entering the game moments ago, and so close to getting UCLA on the board. Terrific save by Boyd. Munnerlin. There's Mejia. Boy, is she solid. Starts the counter. What a great ball. Again. Oh, my goodness. I mean, at the last second, Goralski is trying to clear that ball after Ervic. Kind of lays herself flat and exposed, but goal number 5 on the board in the 67th minute. Ship with the hat trick. My goodness, what a game for Ari Ship.
That ball very well may have been over the goal line and scored before Goralski. We'll see. Doesn't matter. Look at Ervic with the save. But then the ball goes right back in, the follow-up. Look at Ship getting into position. She sees it, the loose ball right there for the rebound.
The one-timer Ship, she had the hat trick against Hawaii, but it's a different thing to get a hat trick against UCLA. 14th goal of the season, if I'm not mistaken. My pencil is just, you know.
Running out of lead?
Well, it's all messed up.
Well, write a note down there with 14 goals that's her second hat trick.
Yep. And again, Ship's reaction is nothing celebratory. She shakes her fist when she assists and just trots over when she scores. Classy player all the way. Not showing up anybody. 5-0 Cal. Again, to remind you that it's been since 2004 since Cal has defeated UCLA, the Bruins on a 10-match win streak. Against this Cal club, and it's going to end today 1-0 at half. And you look at the score now, 5-0, and we're in the 68th minute. And Tammy, after consecutive wins over Colorado and Utah for UCLA, a huge step back for the Bruins as they're getting routed today by this fine Bear club.
Yeah, I mean, this was such an important match for them to go on the road, end of the season, against a quality top-ranked team in Cal, and to be able to beat this team, try to get to their 10 wins, try to help their RPI.
Obviously, it's not a bad loss against
a bad loss,
but they can't afford any more losses.
5-0 and another loss. I mean, they have to go play Stanford in a couple days.
Ooh, Lavrusky trying the bicycle kick.
I love the campus and I love the coaches. That's the first reason why I'm here, is the coaches, and Sheila's great and Clint's also a great coach. I think we do a great job as, you know, as a team on the court and off the court, like helping each other out, like saying, go ASU. Even if they're down or when we're up, I think we do have a good team, you know, and we come together, so it definitely helps us winning. Desiree Krafchick, ASU Women's Tennis, go Devils.
Back to the hat trick moments ago for Ari Ship. Again, off of a rebound, a play that was made near the end line. Oh, she's so good with her feet, but then Ship is right there.
And Ship is taken out of the game and gets a hug from Neil McGuire. 14 goals and 6 assists. 3 of those goals came today, 1 of those assists came today. My goodness. And Tammy, this is a match that Ship, with the 3 goals, easily could have had 5 or 6. If not for the post and for some great saves by Ervic.
Plus, not to mention, if Neil were to keep her in, there's still 20
point.
Minutes left to play.
Great ball by Lavrusky. And there's Boyd again. Wow. Lavrusky has had some wonderful through balls to the feet of teammates, but Boyd has snuffed out every rally.
Just a beautiful cross, beautifully played. This is what Lavrusky can do. Puts the ball right there. Wondering if she one-times it, if she's got a better chance.
She and Serta have combined nicely since McKenzie has come in, but Boyd just won't let anything through. Five nothing, 20th ranked Cal, looking to keep its record perfect at home as Serta is holding her head. Gosh.
Dangerous plays anytime you see a ball, and these two players just trying to do what they do, and that is win the ball in the air, right?
Yep.
That's what they're trained to do. That's what they work on and practice. Unfortunate that those noggins came together and a hard hit. Serta holding the back of her head.
Bure, too.
Mm-hmm.
She walked away holding the side of her head. So it was a head-to-head battle. To your point, Tammy, those 50-50 balls, those balls in the air, you know, you're taught and coached. Got to go up and get those things. So often you see heads hitting, you know, kind of a knock on each other, and we'll see how everything plays out.
Well, there's extra attention paid to head injuries, as well there should, and there are oftentimes tests that are done, concussion tests. We've talked about many, many times. I am not saying that she has a concussion,
no.
But I'm saying the attention to detail with a head injury is something that is part of the game and something that they do in every sport.
Protocols are in place as Serta will walk to the sideline. And they'll give her, you know, just a little bit of an added look, if you will.
Jenkins will come back in as she can re-enter in that second
right.
half. But remember, she's banged up a little bit. She's
yep.
probably not 100%.
So Serta out, Jenkins in. Jenkins leading UCLA with the 5 goals. The closest to the best opportunity UCLA has had was the penalty kick that Alvarado missed. Jenkins tries to redirect that flick header. 59th minute, Alvarado, who's usually money with the penalty kicks, 3 for 3 going into that opportunity, missed badly. Cal has made UCLA pay. Another turnover. Whitteman leaves it for Graff. Just wide. Irvick tracked it well.
And you can see that, you know, they want to go, Cal, that is, they want to go right at that back line of UCLA. They understand that Courtney Proctor will occasionally spill that ball, turn that ball over right there. She just doesn't have that timing fitness.
Yep.
You know, she's still working on that. She deserves time to come back from that injury. And while she's played in several matches this season, not the minutes, and that's a factor.
My mistake, that was Vandy Veeder that was all over that last play, not Graff. Vandy Veeder wearing number 4. UCLA still battling. Bure. Just a little chip. Bure gives it a ride.
You have to be careful with Bure. She's a big target. I mean, she was last year.
Mm-hmm.
No doubt that she's just having the year that everybody thought that she would after a stellar season last year. She had 15 starts, 6 goals, 5 assists. She's a big target, makes herself available, understands soccer, knows where to go, spacing, timing.
I mean, last year really a kind of a career year for Boure as a junior, but still after it this year with the 4 goals and 2 assists. Been a regular starter for McGuire. Well, you're right.
So dangerous in the box. Another weapon for them up top.
They tend to be so aware of where Ify is, Ship, Wittemann, and then Boure can just kind of just hang waiting in the wings, waiting in the weeds.
Well, it doesn't allow your opponent to double and triple when you have so many good players on the opposing team. They've got to match up and mark one-on-one and oftentimes go 1v1. And that's a nice luxury to have if you're Neil McGuire.
Cal just relentless as UCLA has been turning that ball over in their defensive third, and Cal making them pay.
It's such again, we said Amanda Cromwell talks about opposite end of the spectrum. A year last year for UCLA, stifling defense, they had 19 of 24 of their opponents they shut out. They lost all 4 defenders and their goalie from last year.
Yep.
So a team that is rebuilding in that back defensively.
Big time.
Don't forget about Sarah Killian, the best players on the team last year in that holding midfield position. Amanda says that she was the best leader she ever coached, and that's high praise.
Man. Number 32, Ramotko in for Cal now. Again, the step results in the turnover and an easy call to make. Cal not letting up here in the 75th minute. And Mace getting dinged there. And getting booked too. Yellow comes up.
Yellow card presented to UCLA at number 16, Haley Bates.
So that'll result in the free kick for Cal as they just continue to pour it on.
One of those things where Samantha Wittemann does so many of the little things. Draws the fouls, gets the opportunity to set pieces that she creates.
Yep.
Doesn't get enough praise.
Here's Hop. See if there's a cross in the works for this Cal bunch. Instead, good defense in a tag team situation for UCLA will result in a Bruin throw in. Matlich now checking in for UCLA. And if you're UCLA, this game can't get over quickly enough. You're going to keep battling, that's for sure. But
you're
going to 5-0.
That's right. You're going to battle against this player right here who's been battling number 26. We just talked about her, Samantha Wittemann. And
look out. Oh, boy. The touch, and Boure drills it. Her 5th goal of the season. And the rout continues, 6-0 here in the 76th minute.
Best way I can describe Boure, and we talked about her being a great target, strong, so creative, and a good finisher in the box, is that she just knows how to break down a defense, whether that's off a dribble or game situation. She gathers the ball, comes across her body to create a better angle, and with a little bit more space, a left-footed shot.
The touch was just so deft. I mean, right to that foot where she knew she could unleash the shot.
Soft touch as well.
Yeah, Irvik had no chance. 6-0 Cal. And UCLA just wanting to get on the board. Tammy, we've got folks working on numbers, but I just don't recall the last time, if ever, UCLA has lost a game by 6 goals. And this is just unbelievable. Munnerlin loses it. Cal's defense has been that good. What a ball. And again, it was one of those deals where Nile just couldn't wait to get that ball on her shooting foot, and it kind of kicked off the heel of a Bruin, because that sure looked like another golden opportunity. Here's Wally. And Wally with her first goal of the season. The sophomore with her first goal. My goodness. Heather Wally with her first goal of the season.
Well, we told you that Cal was not going to take their foot off the pedal. And the players are going to play as they are trained in practice to play. And they're going to create. And the space is opening up. I mean, the seas are parting for Cal. There's a lot of space in front of them when they get the ball. The defensive breakdown by UCLA is just allowing these opportunities for Cal. And they're taking advantage of it.
A great moment for Wally. Remember, it was 1-0, anybody's match at halftime. 1-0. And that is a correct score. 7-0 Cal. 6 second half goals. One of them, I get it, is a Bruin own goal, but still, you get the idea. Nicely played by Matlich, but she succumbs to pretty good defense there by this Cal group. How good has Cal been defensively today? Basically snuffing out darn near every rally inside that 18 with plays just like that. Stepping in, denying, double teaming, creating turnovers. We've got to be getting near some kind of a record.
When that goal was scored by Heather Wally, Siri Irvik was sitting on the ground just staring, and
yeah,
I felt like her. I mean, I've never seen anything like this before.
This is a very proud UCLA program. And Cal's been chasing them in terms of head-to-head matchups for a long time now. This shot will tell you everything. They're still working, but they've got some kinks to work out.
And I believe that's Amber Munnerlin, who is talking to the team as she got her team in the huddle. And that's leadership right there. You know, she's not talking about what do we do to get back in this match. She's talking about pride and what it means to wear the four letters on the jersey and how to finish strong and not hold your head down. That's great leadership by the transfer from North Carolina, the junior.
A nice moment for Munnerlin, who gathers the troops. I like that a lot. And we're still trying to track down what kind of a record this might be as far as a Cal victory and or a UCLA loss. Corner kick for the Bruins. 8-0. What do you have, TB? 8-0 UCLA. 1997, Notre Dame defeated them 8-0.
In the NCAA tournament.
Good one, TB.
So
thanks, man. That's great stuff.
Fact digging. And the last 21 games versus UCLA, 10 goals today, 7.
Wow. UCLA has owned this matchup. Owned it. Ship with the hat trick. UCLA missing the penalty kick. Everybody getting in the scoring act, it feels like, for this Cal bunch. Smart play there by Nile. And the only thing that would put the cherry on the top would be the clean sheet for Boyd. That would be her 11th shutout of the season if this score stands. And that would put her into a first place tie in terms of single season shutouts. And we're here in the 81st minute. So UCLA lost to Notre Dame, it seems like forever ago, 8-0 in the NCAA tournament. This one's got to feel just as bad.
And I
want to make sure we get the other stat in.
What's that?
We're communicating with Liza David of UCLA, who is feeding us this information. They also had a 7-0 loss to Santa Clara in 1999 in the NCAA tournament.
Okay.
Liza doing some important work for us. Thank you, Liza.
Huge
staff
thank you.
Of UCLA and athletics communications.
Matko will spearhead things from midfield. Well, I'll tell you, I wasn't around for either one of those games. And it's just baffling and almost unbelievable to see that score up there and not think something's out of whack in terms of it can't possibly be 7-0, and it was 1-0 at half. I don't know where to begin as far as this second half is concerned, TB.
Well, all you do is, you know, if you're UCLA, you are putting this one behind you as quickly as possible because you're going to have to face Stanford on Sunday, November 1st at 3:30. So they've got a couple days, today being Thursday. They've got tomorrow, Saturday. Get their mindset right. This one has to be behind them. They can't dwell on it.
Alderetti in for UCLA. And Cal's going to keep working, keep battling. They'll put another goal up if they can, while UCLA just wants to find the back of the net once today. Because believe you me, the coaching staff really checks out who's still working hard as far as the UCLA players on the pitch. 83rd minute. This game was put to bed quickly in the second half.
Here's the wall there that just sits on the right side if you're sitting on the bench of the Cal soccer program. And if you look to the top left, you can see the name Leslie Gallimore. Well, a couple, three or four times maybe, 1982 through 1985. There she is. And she is now the coach of University of Washington, having a great season. These two teams, Cal and Washington, met last week. You were there. Cal could not put the ball in the back of the net. Washington won that game, 1-0. A total difference here today with them with chances and putting the ball in the net.
Every coach emphasizes finishing. And as good as Irvik has been, she has just been peppered. And Cal has made hay on a lot of their chances here in this second half.
And by the way, congratulations to Leslie Gallimore, who was part of the Pac-12 All-Century team, which was just revealed by the Pac-12 Networks. Features a quartet of the California Golden Bears. Joy Fawcett, a household name, women's soccer, also one of them. Alex Morgan, Mary Harvey.
UCLA represented very well.
Yep, absolutely. We talked at length last week about Lauren Holiday, the former Lauren Cheney, UCLA great, who retired from the U.S. Women's National Team this past Sunday with the victory tour for the U.S. Women's National Team that played her last match in Orlando, Florida at the Citrus Bowl against Brazil.
Abby Dahlkemper, one of the starters to make that all-century team as well.
What a dandy, right?
Yep.
One of the great defenders for UCLA who graduated.
85th minute. As both coaches giving a lot of players some very important playing time in this match. I'll tell you, Indigo Gibson has had a really good match for this Cal club. There's a lot of unsung heroes that gives you reason to think that Neil McGuire and this Cal club
could have an interesting postseason run.
Well, she's so good out of the back. How much support does she bring moving forward?
Yep.
That's what allows them. She'll track back, and she'll stop a run. She'll clog a passing lane. But she also does so much for this team as they move forward and build out of the back.
Box to box for sure. There's Gibson. So with the win, Cal will go to 13-4-2. More importantly, Tammy, 6-3-0 in conference play, while UCLA will drop to 8-8-1, 4-4-1 in conference play. Cal stays perfect on or at home.
And you and I have been around sports for a long time. It doesn't matter what sport we're talking about. When it comes time for the end of the season and we're looking at time, it's great to finish strong. And that's what this Cal team is doing.
UCLA still trying to find that back of the net in the waning moments of this match. Inside the 18 now, knocked away. Gibson. Just all over the pitch.
Samantha Winneman and Indigo Gibson, two players that have really stuck out for us in this match today. Just recently named Pac-12 Offensive and Defensive Players of the Week. Several nods from the Pac-12 for this Cal team.
Lots of real estate. Alderetti playing a little combination with Alarab. The Bears led it 1-0 at halftime on Ship's goal.
You know, this is such an important finish and a strong finish as Cal will face USC on Sunday at 1 p.m. They need this momentum, and that's right here.
Yep.
They need this momentum going into a match that a very talented USC, they know how to score. They got a lot of players playing well in positional field positions.
It's a top 20 game right
there. It is a top 20 game. I know USC has to face Stanford tonight, but still looking ahead. And then they have to finish, Cal does, at Stanford.
Yep. So basically, UCLA and Cal just kind of play each other's opponents down the stretch.
Mm-hmm. UCLA will host their final match of the season against USC.
Final home match, and then at Stanford for the finale. Wally giving chase. She had a nifty goal in this second half onslaught. The sophomore with her first goal of the season. Well, heck, it's her first goal of her career.
Of her career.
Yep. That's no wonder the reaction. I mean, there's nothing like it.
Are you surprised by Ship's improvement and development after her slow going because of the injury?
Well, it really it reinforces, especially with this. In this game, how fitness is so paramount mm-hmm. to what you're able to do physically and mentally. She's a different player to me mentally because of the confidence physically.
You know, she's also more composed in front of the goal, and, you know, that helps.
She seems to have slowed the game down, Tammy.
And she simplified it. You know, I talked about just on that goal making a pass to the corner.
Right, right.
And again, I'll say it. How many times have we seen them over kick? And she simplified the game.
Ship with the hat trick and the assist today. So she now sits at 14 goals and 6 assists. Well ahead of everybody else in this very fine conference.
And of course a looming Pac-12 Player of the Week on her next week.
Oh, gee whiz, you bet. So that is the final, Tammy Blackburn. 20th ranked Cal stays perfect at home and defeats UCLA 7-0. And the clean sheet for Emily Boyd is the 11th shutout of the season for this fine sophomore, tying the single season record four shutouts. So beginning, middle, and end, top to bottom, what a win for Cal.
Well, congratulations to a very good team that had to finish strong. They don't have an easy schedule going down the stretch. It all started here today with UCLA, then with USC, and then on the road to Stanford. So a tough schedule, but Cal, I thought, kept their composure, started off strong. Certainly that goal getting on the board in the first half was a big boost. But then when the wheels fell off for UCLA, Cal, pedal to the metal, a well-balanced team.
So standings after this Cal victory vaults the Bears to 6-3-0, a huge win for Cal.
Yeah, they could finish so strong. They don't have any ties. Those three losses, very few, and especially in the Pac-12 and women's soccer conference, so tough. UCLA down there at the bottom falls. Unfortunately, they won't be able to get their 10 wins. Great momentum for Cal.
Well, and if USC can defeat Stanford today, Cal still has an outside chance of winning the conference. They'll need help, but they took a big step today. There's a nice shot of Emily Boyd. Again, the clean sheet and all smiles for her. Her defense, Boyd's defense, was terrific today.
Yeah, she'll be the first to credit her back line that protects her, but once they break that back line, it's all Emily Boyd, and she is coming off of a great year last year as a freshman and having a sensational sophomore year.
1-0, Cal led at halftime. 1-0, the final, 7-0, Golden Bears. What a day for Ari Shipp.
Anytime you dial up a hat trick, it's a special day in Pac-12 women's soccer. It started with a nice goal in the first half to give Cal the lead. It didn't slow down in the second half. The fist pump by Ari Shipp knows the importance of a match and defending your home pitch. Again, slots win in the far post, and as things opened up, she was there on the rebound, finding the open space and understanding the game of soccer. Great composure, great sportsmanship, a hard worker who never takes a day off, and it shows today.
So impressed with the way Cal shared the ball. I'm so impressed with the Bears' runs off the ball. That was clinic offensive soccer, Tammy.
Well, it's a well-coached team, too, by Neil McGuire. Congratulations on what is continuing to be a great season for this coaching staff. And, you know, when I look around the pitch and I watch how plays develop and how they respond to their coach, I think this is a team in Cal that has absolutely bought into the system and the way that they're playing.
More soccer tonight, and it is a biggie as far as Pac-12 women's soccer is concerned. Stanford hosting USC. That's number one against number two in conference play. Should be fun.
Talk about a team in USC that has a great coach, Kadani McAlpine. They are scoreless in 275 minutes, but they are going to get challenged tonight on the farm at Stanford. Sure to be a dandy, and trying to give Stanford, the undefeated Pac-12 team, their first loss in Pac-12.
We talked about Ariel Shipp with the hat trick and the assist. She joins us now. Okay, kiddo, walk us through what kind of day you had. I mean, I don't know if it's just one of those feelings when you got out of bed this morning, but walk us through what it felt like out there on the pitch today.
Well, it was one of those days. UCLA is such a big name, and I think we've been playing great this whole time, and it was a really good team win today. We really came out and were fired up to play them at home, and we got the result we were looking for.
Ari, so much of what you're able to do starts with the buildup and the defense. Your defenders had some great steps, and then buildup kind of happens, and then once it gets inside the 18, you guys are very clever, very crafty.
There was
a lot of space that happened for you, and talk about how you find open space and what you're trying to think about as that ball is moving up the field.
I'm really just looking for little splits, little openings of where I can be crafty and get in behind the defense. My team does a really good job of finding me the ball and helping me get to goal.
And speaking the obvious, how crucial is this game, knowing that you've got a really tough stretch run of games to finish the regular season?
It's really tough. Knowing that we have USC and Stanford these next two games, but this win obviously feels great and helps us looking forward for the future.
Yep. Ari, you appear to be responding very well to Coach McGuire and everything that he's done, rightfully so, great coach. But the team seems like they're all buying in. There's absolutely no dissension. The chemistry is great. And how far can that camaraderie take you?
I think that could take us all the way. We're looking to go to the Final Four. We want to win the national championship this year. And coaching staff, the team, we have it, we believe, and I think that's where we're headed.
Well done, Ari Shipp.
Thank you.
You're welcome. A hat trick and an assist. Nicely done today, young lady.
Thank you.
You're welcome. What a win for the Cal Golden Bears. 7-0, Tammy Blackburn.
Just, again, a very good team, well-coached by Neil McGuire. A lot of fun to watch. Every position, when you break it down, it starts in the goal with Emily Boyd and then the back line. And then as it moves up, I think Indigo Gibson does a nice job. Boy, Samantha Whitman, what more can you say? And how about the finishers and the front runners, Ari Shipp?
So that's a wrap from Edwards Stadium in Berkeley. 20th-ranked Cal drills UCLA 7-0. The Bears' first win over the Bruins since 2004. For Tammy Blackburn and our entire broadcast crew, I'm Ann Schott saying thanks so much for watching Pac-12 Women's Soccer with us, and so long from Berkeley, Bears roll 7-0.